My name is Dhoruba Shakur.
Hi, my name is Sixela Yoccm, and you are watching Rochester Indymedia.
But my first question is just tell me a little bit about yourselves before the shooting of Mike Brown, murder of Mike Brown in Ferguson. Like, who were you guys?
I was a musician in St. Louis, and as well as my hometown, Kansas City, Missouri. And pretty much that's my regular guy with a family. Girlfriend.
Who are you?
Sound more enthusiastic. Before Mike Brown, I too was and still am a regular person with a family, a boyfriend. I'm expecting now, but I guess I was pregnant when Mike Brown. I don't know. I really don't know. But that's new for me, and I was also singing, like, I'm still singing and working on music. I'm not trying to be, like, selling out arenas and stuff, just trying to touch people whatever way I can with music and art and holistic healing, because the pharmaceutical business is a joke. So, yeah, everything that's put here on the earth was meant for us to intake and heal ourselves, so.
So then, Mike Brown's murder by Darren Wilson. Mm-hmm. What pulled you guys in? What made you say? What was the switch for you? Like, what, you know, got you involved?
The imagery. I'm big on imagery, and just to see his body on Twitter. Like, when I first saw it on Twitter, I didn't even think that happened in St. Louis. I was like, oh, that happened in like a Baltimore or New York or something. Then I found out it happened in Ferguson, and I was like, wow. And I honestly didn't expect St. Louis to react the way they did. Like, the people of St. Louis, I expected us to just let this get pushed under the rug like a lot of other things have throughout the years. But I got involved rather quickly because of him, because he jumped on it first, and then I went out to Ferguson and Canfield and got a part of the protest. And as it was progressing and me finding out I was pregnant, I kind of had to like pull back because of the tear gas and a lot of other things that were going on. So, but I'm still very much about it. So if no indictment comes, then I will be back out there, Billy and all. So.
I got involved because it was just a messed up scene, you know what I'm saying? And I had heard about how it happened. And it just bothered me a whole lot. And my friends that were around me, it bothered them too. So he died on August the 9th, which was a Saturday. And then the 10th, the Sunday, me and my friends, we went out there. It was early in the day. And we just couldn't ignore it, you know what I'm saying? It was like, we gotta go down there and see what's going on. Talk to the people that live over there. And yeah, we just couldn't ignore that, so I had to go.
Do you guys have any heroes, or where do you get inspiration from?
The Black Panther Party. Everybody.
That's so broad.
Everybody in the Black Panther Party. Like, there's so many people that I really appreciate. Malcolm X, of course. Stokely Carmichael.
Well, my heroes are the people like me, people who aren't just standing and like passers-by and bystanders like, oh, I feel so sorry for you guys, like I support you, but really aren't doing anything. Like, the heroes are people like Dhoruba, myself, Yusef, Ricardo, people who travel hundreds and hundreds of miles to even come and get a bird's eye view of what's happening instead of listening to CNN. People like yourself who are interested in what's going on instead of just listening to the media and like blaming us. Like, we're the problem, and it's really the system.
Dhoruba, last night you were talking about the Quick Trip gas station burning down. And I think you said that when that happened, you were unsure how you felt about that. Mm-hmm. You said that now you feel confident that that was the right way to go. And I'm wondering, between then and now, like, what was it that changed your politics, or what is it that changed your mind to say that property destruction was the right thing to do?
Because for some reason, even though I knew that it wasn't true, I thought that we were going to be able to get something done by the police for what had happened. Mm-hmm. And as time progressed, they proved me wrong. And many other events that have just gone on since Mike Brown's death, that just, I feel like that was it. That was the only way to get people's attention, the national attention that it's gotten. It inflamed the people around it, you know what I'm saying? Like, people were on fire everywhere. They're just ready to go in the city. And without that happening, I don't know what it would have looked like. I don't even know what I'd be doing right now. I'd probably be trying to look for some job, because the flames died out and nobody wants to do anything. You know what I'm saying? But this, I don't know. It was just looking back on it, it was very beneficial for the people that burned down. As crazy as that may sound to some people.
As a woman in this movement, you know, what is the role of women that you see in the movement? And are you encountering, like, sexism? I mean, are you encountering, like, white supremacy, racism with the organizing that's going on? Like, can you describe a little bit about that?
I haven't personally experienced any of that, but the women that I work closely with, is definitely sexism that happens, because the men automatically feel like they can just dominate and take over, like they can talk over the women when they're trying to make a point. And I feel like that's rude, and everybody is entitled to a voice, and that we birth nations, like, women are powerful, and I feel like we have a right to be on the forefront and bring about change just as much as the men do. And I also feel like our role as women in the movement, or to be supportive of our men, it's not always easy when they don't come home 3, 4, 5 days at a time, especially with Occupy Slew. He was out there 6 days, and I really didn't get a chance to spend, like, quality time with him until we got here to Rochester, which I really appreciate. But you just gotta pretty much hold it together. A lot of relationships have failed because of the movement. Like, their partner couldn't take the them not being present. So, you know, anyone who's involved, I just hope, wish you guys the best, and that you make it through it. Just anybody, you know, husband, wife, kids, you know, a lot of people are spending time away from their kids because they don't want to bring their kids in the midst of it. But just got to push through it and stick it out.
Well, let me say this. Are there any guiding principles or values that you take with you in this fight, in this movement?
Tribex as an organization, the one that I'm with, or one of the organizations that I'm with, we're about educating, organizing, and empowering the people. And I would say, me personally, I just live by giving the people what they need, you know what I'm saying? Like, for too long, the people have been deprived of fundamental things, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And I'm trying to do whatever it is that I'm supposed to do for the movement, so that the people can get the power back and be able to actually live, you know what I mean? Enjoy life, be human beings. Right now, we're being forced in this crazy position, you know what I'm saying? And that's been lost by a lot of people. That's not even like a thought in their brain right now. All they're worried about is going to work, doing whatever it is that they gotta do, not even realizing that they're being taken full advantage of every day. And so I just live by trying to wake people up and reminding people and giving the power to the people in whatever way that I can.
About you, Six, is there any guiding values or principles that you follow?
Hope. is definitely one of them. I mean, you can't lose that. You can't lose your values and your morals as a person. And the integrity of that has to like withstand over everything. Like you can't shift it because certain events are happening in your life and then you just kind of push aside other things. Like you have to have balance. Like that's one thing that I'm really a firm believer of. Like you have to have a balance of all things in life, which keeps you afloat.
Dhoruba, you mentioned Tribe X. Can you talk a little bit about what that is and what Tribe X is doing right now?
Tribe X is an organization. It's about educating, organizing, and empowering. And right now, we're educating, organizing, and empowering.
How did it come together?
Really, it was a group of people, individuals who were on the ground, working together, and got tired of what they were seeing from other organizations, big organizations that was going on. Mm-hmm. So, people, individuals felt like they should get together and create an organization that empowers, educates, and organizes the people. So, that's what we did. What we're doing. We
gotta do it. Excuse me. So you said you're expecting.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm wondering how you guys feel about being parents in the world today.
Dhoruba.
I don't even know. I'm gonna take care of my kid the best way that I can and be a part of this movement the best way that I can.
Well,
just
I'm gonna
a
natural
be a parent
born.
To me, it's not, yeah, it's not anything to even think about. You know what I'm saying? Just be a parent.
And I bring the baby out.
Yeah, she's got the hard part.
What does justice look like in Ferguson for you guys? What is
Black
justice for my
liberation in America?
On top of that, like, a whole reconstruction of the Ferguson Police Department. And once that gets handled, branch it out to St. Louis and Hazelwood. And I just think they need a new way of doing things, a new training of psychiatric evaluation and some of the... Because it's some sick individuals without their uniform. Like, it has to be for you to have no conscience of taking someone's life and it doesn't bother you. You still getting paid, and this is day, what, 75? For your conscience not to eat at you and, you know, like, look, I messed up. To be a man and admit, I messed up. I killed this kid, and it wasn't right, and I'm sorry I put the family and a community through all of this. And I just think people need to take ownership and responsibility of their actions and pay the price for that accordingly. Like, citizens and authority, like, everyone.
What's next? You're going back to Ferguson tomorrow, correct?
Yes.
And then, is it just like you jump back in and run, or like, what happens next?
Jump back in and run, plan, organize.
I mean, he's been having like this feeling for the past few days that we're going to get the news that we don't want to get right now, so.
Yeah, that no indictment's going to come, and we gotta have our people in a place that we need to be when that goes down.
What's,
make sure we're prepared.
What's the worst case scenario in that situation? Or what's the best case scenario in that situation, I guess?
People not dying, I guess. But it will be Ferguson week one, ground zero times 100.
Best case scenario for me, they do the no indictment like they gonna do. The people who are on the fence and the people who weren't paying any attention finally is like, what the hell? That's some weird stuff that's not supposed to happen. They get radicalized and the movement grows even bigger and ripples even bigger all over America. To me, that's the best case scenario.
But for me personally, an indictment is not enough.
Nah, we ain't gonna get one. That's not gonna happen.
But if it does, an indictment and him getting, what, 3 months in jail? Yeah, just an indictment itself doesn't suffice for all the pain that we went through. So I think, you know, Ferguson's got a lot of work to do. And you said they threw out, like, a lot of the civil cases, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Well, I just want to thank you both for your time today. Do you have any last comments before you get whisked away to RIT? No. I know, it's a lot.
Encourage everyone to get involved.
Definitely get involved where you are, because it's messed up shit.
You cannot dictate what help looks like.
Yeah. Allies, please don't try to dictate what the help looks like. Just help in whatever ways you can.
And don't pay attention to CNN, Fox, MSNBC. You go to Twitter right now and type in the handle DHORUBASHAKUR, which is his Twitter handle, or Tribe X's Twitter,
which is TribeX_STL.
TribeX_STL and Freedom Fighters. That's three for sure tags where you're going to get
Freedom
all
the... Freedom Fighters tag is FF_STL. And you can get info from all those Twitters.
All reliable sources.
What's going on the ground in Ferguson and St. Louis. And just be a part of what's going on in your community and amplify that and show solidarity. And we show solidarity and let's get some things done.
I agree.
Well, thank you both for your time and coming out
today.
Thank you. Yeah.
I mean, I say what I mean, I am not co-signed by Jimmy Iovine. I will not go blind from things I've seen. Third eye and it's on high beam. Will these cops go to jail for? Ever gonna John Crawford's jail for?
I your Michael Brown resurrected to strike you down.
Seeing Ferguson, they murdered him. Call the cops, then the purge begins. Bring tanks to herd him in and tear gas that burns the skin. 40 cal, 50 cal, 60 cal guns. Lights, camera, action now. Reverend now comes.